From the day that it opened in 1912, the Helen Hayes, formerly the Little Theater, was the unique vision of one man, Winthrop Ames.
Ames came from a very, very wealthy New England family. He studied architecture, but he loved theater. And then he moved to New York and eventually decided that he was going to build his ideal perfect theater.
Winthrop Ames was interested in what was called the Little Theater Movement, with its focus on intimate drama for small audiences. He hired architects Harry Ingalls and F. Burrall Hoffman to help him come up with the perfect design.
The Little Theater looks like a colonial house in New England. It's red brick. It's laid in what's called Flemish bond, which is alternating long bricks and short bricks. And this was the way that houses were built in New England in the 18th and early 19th centuries. Inside the theater, which seated 299 people, it was very elegantly ornamented in English neoclassical or Adamesque design. It was as if you were in the living room. Everything was designed to make theater into a homey, intimate experience.
Even though a balcony was added to increase seating capacity to 500, and Ames was successful in producing hit plays, by 1931, he was forced to sell. Through the 40s, 50s, and 60s, the theater became a television studio. Then, in 1978, the Westinghouse Broadcasting Company sold the theater to independent businessmen Marty Markinson and Donald Tick.
And so I went to my partner, who was Jeffrey's father, and I said, I want to buy a theater. He said, you're crazy. I convinced him, and we went ahead and bought the Helen Hayes Theater.
So the partnership that my father and Marty had was wonderful. They'd never had a fight in all the years that they were partners, and I can say the same thing with Marty and I.
Their first hit play, Torch Song Trilogy, written by and starring Harvey Fierstein, began as a risky off-Broadway sensation.
There were all these people that wanted to move it to Broadway, and we were like so sold out. I said, this thing's gonna run forever and I wanna go on with my life, so what do I do? And I said, you know what, I'll let it move to Broadway because I'll have a Broadway credit and it'll close because it couldn't possibly run on Broadway.
For the first 8 months, we were losing money every single week, but we knew the play was really good, and so we kept putting our own money in.
We got to award season and then won all these awards, and then off we went.
And it ran 3 years in our theater. That was what put the theater on the map.
In 1983, after the original Helen Hayes Theater had been demolished, the Little Theater was renamed in her honor.
Helen Hayes was born in 1900, and her career really spans most of the 20th century. She was one of the most beloved actresses in American theater, and she was called the First Lady of the American theater.
Through the years, the Helen Hayes has been able to survive with intimate plays and musicals, including Prelude to a Kiss, starring Mary Louise Parker.
I didn't know the Helen Hayes. I didn't go to the theater. I didn't have any money to go to the theater. I remember where I was standing, literally in my crappy studio apartment, when I opened the envelope and started reading that script. And I remember that I just kept standing there at the table, and I was so transfixed by it and by those words, and I just knew they were just already in me.
I would really, really like to see you with all your clothes off and stuff like that.
I would really, really like to see you with all of your clothes off and
stuff like that.
Really changed me as an actor more than any other experience I ever had.
Maybe we should just watch some TV, have happy memories of this and anticipate the future. We shouldn't.
In 2012, the Helen Hayes celebrated its 100th birthday with a party at the legendary Sardi's restaurant. Keeping alive the vision of Winthrop Ames, the Helen Hayes continues to give audiences an intimate theatrical experience.
The audience really feels like another character in the play. Sometimes everything becomes really, really quiet. You can feel people breathing, and you could feel someone in the balcony all the way in the back. You can feel their heartbeat. It's indescribable.